So it's nice to be here with you again. I missed you so much. position. She was a very interesting person. But she was a little cavalier about the pandemic, and that led to me getting really, really sick for like 2 months. And so I realized that I was gonna have to just like bite the bullet, like increase my cost of living and make her happen. But I found a place. Lots of light for the plants. And I can just sit here in the afternoon and record an ASMR video. I'm still working from home, which is really nice. And, you know, I can like not wear makeup, and just like I'm wearing this business shirt but like a pair of gym shorts. Channels like Goodnight Moon and Zoe Kravitz on Super Bowl commercials doing like beer opening ASMR. And my parents calling me and being like, was that what you were on about at the Hammer Museum like back in the day? And I was like, yes, that's the stuff. That's the audio drug I'm talking about. See that? Mainstream now, baby. Who saw that coming? I kind of like it. I talk about it a lot more freely now. Like, I'll mention ASMR under any circumstance and not feel weird about it at all. And if somebody doesn't know what I'm talking about, well, they have the opportunity to go find out. It used to be a lot more embarrassing, right? Or like secretive. Like, I didn't want people to know that I was letting Russian women whisper in my ear all night long. To somebody, I don't even care. So I got a master's degree in communication in 2020. I was working on it between 2018 and 2020. And I really built up my DJing business a lot too. And I've been working at the same job for 4.5 years, which as an old millennial who graduated into the Bush era economic crisis, this has been the longest that I've been able to keep a job and a salary. Mistakes I've made in the past. And that's what you are witnessing right now. I never used to do the like second check where I would like do all the numbers on the calculator and then convert it to PDF. I would just like type all the numbers in and convert it to PDF in real time, and then I would send it over to my boss for review. And I realized that like she never reviewed them. She just said she did. So then they would get sent out, and then all the errors would show up, and then I would have to like answer for all of them. So instead of having like a really terrible next couple of weeks where I'm answering for all these mistakes I accidentally made. detail-oriented and couldn't. I am checking my work. I know this seems so simple, such a simple concept, but it took me a long time to learn that sometimes one extra step makes your life so much easier. Attention disorder ways, you know what I mean? I guess that's why I like talking to y'all and making an ASMR video while I'm working is actually really helpful, because when I'm just alone and I'm trying to work on this, I'm so easily distracted by everything. But when I'm filming, didn't screw up as much as I thought I had when I was trying to rush through the first part of this. My goal is to have all, like, 600 of these checked and converted by the end of the day, and I'm, like, slightly more than halfway done right now, I think. I also have to read through and make sure, like, my grammar's correct. Like, I swapped out the correct paragraphs and the correct dates, like 2020. Sometimes when I would cut and paste the financial numbers from the spreadsheet, it would mess up the formatting. So I have to make sure that the formatting is showing up correctly too. -750. So this is like a multifaceted process that you're witnessing. Records can get you out of trouble no matter where you are, or which records like boogie, you're like, oh, well, I only have boogie, but, like, this has, like, goth influences production. So you can kind of make people happy, too. All of these things have happened, by the way. I had a gig last summer, like, a masked up gig in Venice Beach, and I had one guy who was, like, celebrating his birthday, and he kept on coming up and putting in requests, but he was getting, like, she was